Greetings of the day, dear students. As we are discussing about many anatomical principles for engineering design aspects, let us discuss two more concepts like echolocation and a countercurrent heat exchange mechanism, which is existing in living biological system. So from that application has originated for the engineering design. So let us look into those aspect. The echolocation or the echolocator in bats and aquatic mammals, you can see like our sonar system, sound navigation and ranging system, and its application is been also seen in submarines. Sonar is been applied in submarine, but the same biological phenomena is existing in bats and aquatic mammals. We will see that concept. And also there is a mechanism called as countercurrent heat exchanging concept. So this mechanism is existing in large fish as well as aquatic mammals, and the same mechanism is also there for brain cooling system of hoofed mammals. The ultimately countercurrent heat exchange mechanism is widely accepted today in industry as such. So you see, for heat exchange, so this mechanism is been utilized. Let us discuss these two concepts in detail. Coming to this echolocator or echolocation concept, you can see this picture here, and a bat is identifying a small mosquito. Not only by seeing, there are some wave patterns you can observe, and also an aquatic fish that is been detecting small fishes, either it may be its food or maybe the communication between these fishes is taking place through some sound waves or waves pattern you can see here. And same thing is been seen, the realistic application of this phenomena. This is a submarine, so which is sending some signals to the shore or to the nearest object, and there is a communication between these things. So all these things you can correlate. So let us see that part. And coming to this bats echolocation concept, so bats are, instead of relaying their sense of sight, they navigate in the dark and find their food, okay, with the help of high pitched squeaks called as ultrasounds. So these sounds are too high for people to hear. You know, we can't hear these things because their wavelength is more than 20 kilohertz, so we can't hear that. So that is the bats which are using their using this waves to find out even the size, shape and texture of any tiny insect. So you can visualize this thing. When that sound is hitting to an object, that echo comes back to this bat, and this bat can identify the object by that sound of the echo, and they can accurately judge the position of any obstruction. Especially even if you see these bats, when they fly, they will not hit easily to any of the wall, because they have got a very accurate determination of the distance every time. So that is how you can visualize their ability by the help of sound waves and getting the information. So that is actually the it is nothing but ultrasonic sounds which are used with constant frequency, long tone, often with some harmonics. They will send this thing with specific velocity also, and most of them are frequency modulated. You can see these ultrasonics as a short burst of sound with the range determined, okay. Always this is the technical aspect of these ultrasonic sound. same principle of echolocation or something like locating by the help of natural mechanism is existing with whales communication also, aquatic mammals you can call them. So they use clicks and whistles are the main type of vocalization that they have, and by the help of that signature whistle, so you can call their whistle itself, because they can recognize each other and also they can communicate each other. One more better application is also found for these aquatic mammals to find their prey, especially the small fish, right? So they can visualize those small fishes of their food, even with the size, shape, distance, internal structure. Most of the time they can get it by the help of this echolocation principle. So let us see a specific part of anatomy of this whale's head for this sound reception. And this structure, you can just visualize how complicated it is, but we will be discussing only the basic major concept. So the melon, the rounded region of the whale's forehead, you can see here, which consists of lipids and fats, okay. So this is how you can visualize the biological structure is there, which will be acting like any of our electronic system, okay. So just see this concept. So the melon acts as an acoustic lens. So here for this fish, so it is going to be an acoustic lens. It's not its natural eye as such. It is a lens of, you can call with sound, acoustic word you can see here, to focus the sound waves into a beam which is projected forward into water in front of the animal. They will send this sound waves, and later you just see the major areas of sound reception. After moving that sound waves, those reflected sound waves will be received by the fat filled cavities of lower jaw bones here. So this is the typical structure of a whale consisting of those parts for echolocation, okay. So just you can visualize, the sounds are received and conducted through the lower jaw portion here, somewhere you can see the arrow marks, to the middle ear and inner ear, then to the hearing centers in the brain via auditory nerve. So all these things will be helping ultimately for the whale to identify its prey or its food to the exact distance it can measure, okay. The brain receives the sound waves in the form of nerve impulse. Actually, those nerve impulses are these messages have been, sound waves have been interpreted, interpreted, and whale will be able to find out its prey. So this is what we call, whales use echolocation to find the capture the food, and you can call this as actually the nature's sonar, okay. I hope you know the word sonar, sound, navigation and ranging, which is the idea which used there as sound bouncing back, similar to the principle of echolocation, which is widely utilized in submarine application to find out group of fish. Also you can use these from the ship, you can send some signals, sound waves, and get back those sound waves and analyze where the group of fishes are all about. And also you can find out the submarine, if you are finding out the submarine down to the ocean, you can send the sound waves and get it back, and you can visualize. And because of that, there are some issue that has been already arisen. The sound waves, whichever we are sending through that sonar, it is actually disrupting the dolphins or fishes ultrasound system. As we have seen, they have got a natural echolocation as well as communication principle, and this has been disrupted. But still, most of the application we are using sonars for identification. Okay. So let us see a small video which is showing you this concept, echolocation with bats and aquatic mammals. And, so when this bat sends that signal, you can see it can identify the small moths or any insect. Okay, so that is we call echolocation. Okay, same principle with the aquatic fishes, large fishes, you can see they can also identify crab or any of those organisms by the help of the echolocation principle. And finally, we will see a realistic application which we already discussed. It is the sonar, okay. So, sonar system from the submarine point of view. You can use that sonar system for finding out submarine or submarine to communicate to the seashore. So, that was the wide application what you can see, okay. Let us move to the next concept called as counter current heat exchanging in large fish as well as aquatic mammals. So, counter current heat exchange is a common mechanism in organisms that utilizes a parallel pipes, what you can call, they are nothing but blood vessels, okay, arteries and veins, which you might have aware when you are studying about the heart, you know, circulation system. You might have heard these arteries and veins, okay. So, veins carrying deoxygenated blood, arteries carrying oxygenated blood. I hope all of you remember this concept of fluid, you know, flowing the fluid actually in opposite direction in order to save the energy. Now, counter current, you can see this word. If it is the word concurrent, that means two fluids moving in the same direction. If it is the word counter current, you can easily understand that two fluids will be moving in opposite direction with the difference in heat, okay. Both of them are not having the same temperature and their temperature is varied, and actually this has been utilized in these large fishes to avoid the you know, heat loss to the environment. You can see one example is given as tuna is a large fast swimming fish of the marine environment. It has a core body temperature of around 36 degree, just like a mammal, and that is why even though it is a cold blooded creature, we call that fish as warm blooded one, okay, because its body temperature is somewhere around 36 degree. And also while swimming, a higher amount of heat is generated in the core of the body due to its muscle action. So you can visualize here. So this is you know, what happens when arteries are surrounded by veins in the muscular actually this system, you can see arteries and veins here. Blue colored one are the veins and red colored one are the arteries. So arteries and veins are surrounded in a proper fashion. You see, just that is how the arrangement made by the natural system. And by transferring the heat to the incoming cold venous blood, it is preheated before it reaches to the core of the body, and thus body temperature is balanced by counter current heat exchange mechanism. You can see either the cold blood or the hot blood, any of these concepts exist with between these veins as well as arteries. So definitely there is ultimately a balance by the help of counter current heat exchange mechanism, okay. So this is what the concept is all about. And let us have a small video explaining this concept with a very good background music. You can understand this concept easily. You understood the concept. So one fluid flows, just you can visualize, with 33 degree moving towards one direction, and another fluid is maybe coming by 27 degree, and at the end of the process, so the balancing will occur, okay. So very good heat transfer will take place by this kind of mechanism. If two fluids flow in the same direction with the difference in heat, there may be a less effective heat transfer, but when they move it in opposite direction, So there will be a very good heat transfer as well as final heat balance. So this is the concept even utilized with the industries. So let us see that concept also when it has been seen in industry thing. So how you can visualize or utilize this concept for that fluid flow, let us see with one more small video. So you can see, this is a typical system of fluid flow. So you can see the red mark arrows indicates the hot fluid, and the blue one is the cold fluid you can consider. And when they move in opposite direction, okay, there is a very good heat transfer. So this is what exactly the heat exchanging counter current heat exchanging mechanism utilized in industry as such. Okay, so the same concept you can see one more once again with whales, dolphins and seals and other marine mammals like sea lions, walrus, sea cow, etc. They can generate their own heat and maintain the body temperature. Okay, because these mammals, okay, these marine mammals, we call them as warm-blooded because I hope you all know what are the creatures with warm-blooded and cold-blooded. So cold-blooded, they cannot they can adjust to the environment temperature, their body temperature they can adjust, but warm-blooded one, they have to maintain their temperature at specific body temperature, because as we all know, we are all warm-blooded one. Our temperature is somewhere around 36 to 37 degree, so we have to maintain that, otherwise we may find it uncomfortable, right? So this is how that same mechanism exists with the marine mammals as such. So they are all called as warm-blooded creatures. And how these marine mammals, even though there is a too much cold environment in marine space, how these fishes will be maintaining their temperature? Let us see. To maintain a constant body temperature, the core of the body, by having counter current heat exchangers in their flippers and flukes. Okay, you can see a very critical arrangement of arteries and veins here, similar one which we have seen for large aquatic fishes, and that concept has been utilized here. The warm blood that flows in the arteries actually is pre-cooled into the peripheral temperature before it reaches to the periphery by transferring the heat to the venous blood. And here you can see a very clear-cut concept. See, arteries will be most of the carrying of slightly warm blood, because arteries carries oxygenated blood, as I mentioned, and that blood will be coming from the heart side. So this will be hot, and veins will be carrying the blood from all part of the body, which you can call deoxygenated blood. So that blood will be most of the time cold, okay, cold in nature. So that cool blood has to be somewhat need to be pre heated, or you can think of you can have a warm blood that is need to be pre-cooled. Anyway, the ultimate balance of heat will take place through these arteries and veins by the help of counter current mechanism. So that is how the core body temperature is maintained constant and heat is not actually lost to the environment. So there only balancing occurs by the help of counter current heat exchange mechanism. So I hope you understood this concept with marine mammals as such. Okay, and there is a very interesting counter current heat exchange mechanism even for the brain cooling system of some of the hoofed mammals. So you can visualize the picture of these hoofed mammals, because these are all the specific images of those mammals you can see here. So most impressive land mammals they are, and rhinoceros, horse, camel, giraffe, all those animals you can see. These animals have hard nail like case called a hoof. You can see here in their leg, these each toe is covered on their feet. So that is how they that is why they called as hoofed mammals. Okay, so they are divided into two groups even again, so even as well as odd toed. Okay, Even toad means deer, pig, and cattle, they have got two toes there, and in some of them have you may have odd, okay, odd toed thing, around 3 or 5, something like that. So you can visualize that concept, even toed as well as odd toed hoofed animals, okay. So the concept is towards you know, because of these hooves, they are able to run very fast, and because since they are running very fast, when they are persuaded by the predators, they will run very fast. What happens by running very fast? It leads to the generation of high body temperature. You know, its core body temperature can reach even up to 42 degrees Celsius near the heart. And this hot blood, if it reaches to its brain, and it may lead to convulsion and instantaneous death due to the overheating of the brain. But still, this is not occurring in nature, because to prevent this, there is an adaptation called as counter current heat exchange mechanism, which we just discussed right now. So that will be preventing the hot blood reaching the brain of these animals. So let us see that system, and you know, understand how that you know, cooling occurs before that you know, blood reaches to the brain. Okay, so it consists of, you just visualize this structure. Again, this is the anatomical feature. So that is how in this unit also, unit 2, you will be discussing about the anatomical principles, okay, and then which has been applied in engineering design. We have just seen the counter current heat exchange mechanism applied in industry, but same mechanism exists in many living systems, okay. So it consists of a sinus called as cavernous sinus, okay. You just see cavernous sinus here. So this part has been mentioned here, and it is the enlarged portion of the jugular vein, one of the vein of the these animals. Okay, so it is the extended portion you can see here. Okay, just remember these technical terms for this, you know, for the understanding of that thing. So this sinus is situated just below the brain, and it is connected to the nasal vein coming from the nasal mucosa. From the nose side, you see there is a vein coming from the nose. Okay, the blue one you can always refer for veins, and the red one you can refer for the arteries, okay. So your nasal mucosa you can visualize here. The carotid artery emerging from the heart actually enters the sinus and split into network of small capillaries called carotid reti. So this is the line coming from the heart, okay. This artery line is coming from heart, and it has been divided into two, carotid artery as well as carotid reti. So here is a network, you know, mesh kind of arrangement. Just you see, you just visualize that concept. At one point of carotid reti and carotid artery, it merges to the brain, and then supplies to the then blood is supplied to the brain. Okay, the blood drained from the nasal mucosa by the nasal vein is cooled to 26 degree by fast respiration action. Now we said, like, even though that hot blood is coming from the vein, is not directly entering into the brain system, and animal is not dying, we said, right? Just like the body temperature is around 42 degrees Celsius when these animals run very fast, but even though that much you know, higher temperature is existing, it has been cooled by the help of its fast respiration action in the nasal mucosa side. And that cool blood with 26 degree is definitely coming. So that is how the hot blood coming from the heart, somewhere around you know, from this region. So in the carotid artery is cooled to the at the cavernous sinus, this part, to 37.5 degree, and which is coming from the you know, almost very cool blood coming from the nasal side, and the these you know. you know, animals are not dying because of that concept. Okay, so this finishes your topics, dear students, and thanks for learning this course, Biology for Engineers. Okay, thanks for learning Biology for Engineers course, dear students. We wishes all the best for all of you. Myself, Dr. Santosh Pujari, and Dr. Chetan DM, and Mrs. Loyola Govias, for your great future. Thanks a lot.